Morning pages and journaling are very different practices. They're both valuable, but in different ways and require different approaches. In this video, we're going to look at what to do if you're finding morning pages or journaling difficult. What if you're struggling? Are your morning pages just taking too long? Journaling is about reflection and expression. Do you find those things hard? I'm going to tell you some truths about journaling and morning pages and the skills you need to make the most of them. First, morning pages. By writing morning pages, we can learn things about ourselves, see ways forward, and discover creative ideas. By journaling, we can tell our stories, and we can rewrite those stories if we want to. We can commit our truth to paper, and in doing so, make it real. Earlier, I described morning pages and journaling as practices. Practices not only in that we do them regularly, as routines or rituals, but because they are techniques that take practice. They are tools we can use to help us find our way in life. And use of any tool has to be learned, and the tool of writing is no different. And only with time will our use of that tool become efficient and effective. Morning pages is built upon a foundation that sounds simple. Don't think, don't stop, just write. That's what everybody says, and it sounds so easy. But a lot of people don't find this easy. This can be because at first we're so used to editing ourselves. In one of my earlier videos, I said that if you do kind of run out of things to say, then you just write and so it goes over and over again. You just keep writing until something else clicks in. These days I tend to write, so what else? And something generally slots into place pretty quickly. But what do you do if nothing does? What do you do if nothing happens after writing the same line over and over again? Someone commented on one of my morning pages videos. She said, "It feels like there's an extra step in this process that everyone is doing, but no one is describing. Why people write about what they choose to write about." But a key thing here is that in morning pages, you don't choose. Choosing is steering, selecting, editing, making conscious decisions about what goes onto the page. But morning pages should not be edited. You have to relinquish all control. Open your mind and write the thoughts that emerge. It's this release of control that we find so difficult, because in life we live under the illusion that we are in control, when in reality we control almost nothing. Morning pages' true power is in the fact that they are an unfiltered, unrestrained flow of thoughts from the unconscious mind onto the page. And people new to morning pages don't know what they're going to get out of it. I was the same. I saw the look on the faces of these two writers I really admired when they spoke of morning pages, and that really intrigued me. But I didn't understand what was so special about this writing that we have to do first thing in the morning. I didn't know. These days, writing morning pages takes me about half an hour, but it wasn't always like that. I had to practice, and looking at some of my morning pages from previous years, I'm surprised it didn't take more than 5 minutes. The margins were wide and the writing was large. I kind of equated the don't stop thing to having to write quickly, rushing even. Almost as if I had to get those pages filled before my subconscious thoughts evaporated. And I've learned that it doesn't have to be like that. I should say I've also recently switched from the standard A5 size that a lot of people use for morning pages. This is an old Lurk term, 1917 A5 medium, hardcover they call it, which I used for a long time. Julia Cameron, as I've said in another video, uses US letter size. This is a Midori MD notebook, and this is where I noticed the margins and the writing really shrank down what I was doing in morning pages. And what I use now is a Moleskine Cahier B5 composition size, and that's why it's taking longer than it used to. It's why I'm taking half an hour rather than, you know, 20-25 minutes, which I was doing with these books. I think it's taking half an hour even though I'm not rushing as much. I think that extra space, the extra room, the extra thinking time you get, even though you're not thinking, as I've said, is actually valuable. But if you're just starting out, just do A5, 3 pages. If 3 pages is too much, do 1.5. This shouldn't feel like a chore. And as Julia Cameron and lots of others point out, myself included, there are no rules. This writing shouldn't make you tense or stressed. But I think it's important, crucial even, that you're not properly awake when you do it, that you're not polluted by the day, subject to external influences. Don't look at your phone before you do this. Phones are full of other people's voices, bad news and stress. If possible, don't even talk to anybody. You're trying to tap into a pure, untainted stream of thoughts direct from your mind. And that's where the practice of morning pages differs so much from journaling, because journaling is where you think. While writing morning pages is about tapping into the unconscious, journaling is more considered reflection. Journaling is about recording events in your life. Journaling is about giving your take on what's happened, what people said and did, how you felt about things. It's about telling your story. It's about writing your truth. And telling your story, writing that truth, requires reflection, and reflection can be difficult. Reflection forces us to judge ourselves. We have to revisit, think, feel and process. Often when we do reflect on things, it's at a fairly superficial level, and our approach very often isn't balanced. What we do find easy is to criticise ourselves. We're good at that. Where we went wrong, where we didn't do well, where we failed. But on the flip side, praising ourselves isn't something we tend to do so much. We don't point out what we did right, where we won the day. But that kind of positive reflection is just as valid and valuable. Now, I'm not saying go and look in the mirror and give yourself a motivational pep talk, but it is a bit like that. Morning pages and journaling are techniques to find your way. But with morning pages in particular, I think a lot of people are looking for a quick return on investment, life-changing insights overnight. I think I was. But that's not what you're going to get. You've got to put in the time. Accept that any kind of writing is a skill to be learned, but it is worthwhile investing that time. And I believe that the days you really don't want to do it are the days it can be most valuable. Put in the practice. You won't know what the rewards will be, but there will be rewards. You can write your truth. You can write your life. You can write your stories. You can rewrite your stories. Invest the time. And invest in yourself. I do three sides. An unfiltered, unrestrained flow of thought. If you've enjoyed this video, why not check out one of these others? And if you can click like and subscribe, that really helps the channel. Thanks a lot.